we all know that plastics contain a whole host of toxic chemicals. We're finding it in our beer, in our salt, and honey, in the Arctic. That in itself is pretty alarming because these plastics never go away. They just continue to break down into smaller particles. Eckerd College is working on a 3-year grant to look at microplastics in the Tampa Bay surface waters and the sediment.
Are we ready if I put it in?
Important for management. And it helps us to understand if policies and actions and regulations are actually working to reduce microplastics in Tampa Bay. So you can see the plankton kind of leaves a mark on the net, all that dark organic material on there. Let's see what we got. That right there looks, it doesn't look biological, that little white piece there. But you can kind of see our water sample. The greatest number of microplastics that we found were fibers. That can come from synthetic clothing, fishing nets, lines. Then the second largest category were fragments, and those come from the breakdown of larger plastics. So plastic bottles, bags. Microplastics cause physical problems to any organisms that potentially ingest them. It can be blockages in their intestines, it can cause starvation, but along with that, bring toxic chemicals. We know that microplastics make their way up the food chain, and we are part of the food chain, so I think that we're gonna see maybe more emerging research that tries to look at the link between microplastics and the effects on human health. This is a big issue to face, so I think that it not only requires a change of our mind, but a change in our hearts. And for me, the best way to do that is to have a strong purpose in your daily life of why you want to reduce the use of single-use plastics.